Hi everyone, and welcome to the DC Public Library STEM Time. I'm Miss Tara. So STEM Time is when we focus on science, technology, engineering, and math. And today we're going to focus on two of those concepts. We're going to focus on the science and technology pieces of STEM. And we're going to look at the concept of photography, the art of photography, and what it is. This is a three-part video series. What is photography? It's taking a lasting, durable image of objects. Those objects could be a dog, a cat, a person. It could be a tree, or a hill, or a lake. It could be a basketball, or a tennis ball, or soccer. It could be a sofa filled with family members. The idea behind photography is that you're able to take that lasting image of those objects by recording light. That's right. This is where the science part comes in. It's all about how the light hits those objects. That is what enables us to create a picture, a durable, lasting picture. Now, there's all different types of cameras, because cameras is what we use in order to make photography happen. So this is a camera. And I should pop this off. This is the lens of the camera. Back here is where I would be looking through to take the picture. And then a lot of us have cameras like that look like this on our cell phones. And the camera, see my cell phone's in a case, and the camera is back here exposed so it can take the picture. Some of us are used to having grown-ups pull out their cell phones, our caregivers pull out their cell phones and quick snapping pictures of us. Some of us have cell phones ourselves and often will use the cameras that are installed on the cell phone that are a part of the cell phone to take the pictures. And we call those selfies. Now there's often, like right now, I'm using the camera on my laptop in order to be able to record this video and talk with all of you. So cameras can be in a lot of different places, but the idea is that you're using the camera lens to take a durable picture, and you're only able to take that durable picture by recording the light as it hits whatever you're trying to take a picture of. That is the concept of photography. So photography and the ability to use cameras really comes about because of artists. And basically, photography is from the Greek words meaning drawing with light. And that's literally what happened, is that many years ago, before there were cars, restaurants, before there were shopping stores like Target or big grocery stores like Giant where you might be buying your groceries, there wasn't cameras. And matter of fact, not too long ago, cell phones didn't exist. And cell phones, when they first started being in existence, didn't feature the camera as part of it. Hard to believe, but true. So the idea of an artist wanting to capture something real, like what you would see with your human eye, the naked eye, it has been said that nothing focuses faster than the human eye. And if you've ever paid attention to how you're able to see things, you're able to see things directly in front of you, and you also have something called peripheral vision. And peripheral vision is when you're able to see things out the side too. And artists loved capturing things, but they wanted to capture things as realistically as possible at times. And they needed to play with light in order to do this. And one of the ways that they did this was through something called a camera obscura. So the camera obscura literally means dark chamber. And a camera obscura is basically capturing this natural optical illusion that happens when you have an image and you're looking through a small pinhole at that image. Take a look at the next graphic to see what I'm talking about. Now, which hole do you look through? And then you're looking at the pinhole, okay? And now you're going to want to do this as you look at light, okay? So look at something with a lot of light and see what you see. Are you able to see a full sofa or a chair or whatever is in your house? Then try it at a window, okay? And then I want you to go outside and try it with your caregiver's permission or when you're on your daily walk wearing your mask. And then take with you, see, you thought I was just sloppy, but really I want you to take with you a blanket. And I want you to hide yourself under the blanket and go like this. And see if that helps you see even better through your pinhole camera or your camera obscura, okay? So a lot of different things for you to try once you've created this. I want you to try looking at it in your house, out the window from one of the windows of your house. I want you to try it outside when you're out getting your daily exercise with your caregiver. And then I want you to try it outside, get permission first, take a blanket with you, drape it over your head, and then look at some kind of object, like look at a tree and see if there's any differences there. And when you're all done, think to yourself, wow, this led to photography? You're gonna be really, really surprised that this led to photography, but it did. All right, until next time, I am Miss Tara. I hope you have fun playing with your camera obscura. Thank you so much for joining me for STEM Time. Don't forget that this is a special STEM Time where we are focusing on photography, and there's actually a secret reason why. And I'm gonna start revealing that when I see you next time, because this is a video series. So get ready to learn something top secret that is about to be revealed within the library. And we'll start that in the next time you see this video, me talking about photography in this video series. Until then, remember to check us out at dclibrary.org. We're always open online. Take care.